Yes, I believe in God.
I admire Jesus, his in the Bible, and want to follow him. I believe that the theory of evolution is the best explanation we have so far for our material origins and how things have been created. Yes, there is evidence for the theory of evolution. I have read, I'm not a scientist and I haven't tested them myself, but I've been convinced by a variety of evidence that I've read in various different sources. Firstly, the fossils, not just the fossils themselves, but how, where they're placed in the geographical strata and layers of the planet. The DNA, I've read Francis Collins, one of the leading scientists in America, description of DNA. It makes me want to worship God, the description of DNA and how he created us. But it also suggests that we are very, very alike to other animals and creatures by our similarities in our DNA structure. And also the Wallace's findings in the Philippines area, islands down near Australia, where he found how animals developed and naturally selected by the environment they're in, and where they can't cross natural divides, they haven't developed. I think all these are pointers and signposts to the fact that evolution is the best theory we have for how we originated. Staring at your wall, you stay on the path you're walking, even though you're wrong. Yeah, so I've watched Ray Comfort's video and I'm a bit confused by what he means by kinds. I've never heard any scientist refer to things as kinds. But what we know is, I've heard people refer to species and refer to different animals as species, and it's what it seems to take place is there is a gradual development that we can measure, but we haven't measured an entire sequence from one species to another. I admit that, but the evidence is there that animals can develop into different species. No, I wouldn't expect any scientist to prove it, because I don't. So here's Ray Comfort's asking for evidence, one piece of evidence. There is none. You couldn't get one, because the theory of evolution says this happens with small adaptations over a long period of time. I think it would be hundreds of thousands of years, if not. Yeah, for even. Well, I guess natural selection could happen quite quickly. Yeah, an animal could be wiped out quite quickly because of a change of environment. But natural environment plus the gradual mutations and animals being, it must take hundreds of years. Everybody's faking, but some of us are breaking over here. Yeah, definitely, I'm not denying that. I And I think that's the greatest thing that Ray Comfort's video does do, is prove that everyone relies on faith. There may be some scientists who have concluded through the evidence that... I mean, I don't think the evidence is as conclusive as people would like to suggest, but it's the best explanation we have. Billions at best at the moment, best estimates I do believe, something like 5-6 billion at the moment. Everybody's faking, but some of us are breaking over. Yeah, this is certainly where I definitely differ from Ray Comfort. I wouldn't use Genesis 1 as a text to say that this is an account. I think my biggest disagreement with Ray Comfort is that he is using Genesis 1 to 3, that text, as a 21st century Enlightenment scientific textbook of how things were created. And I think he is not being respectful to the Bible. The Bible, being respectful to the Bible, is interpreting it in its cultural context. And the ancient Near Eastern cultures, which Genesis 1 is based off, there's several very similar stories in ancient Near Eastern culture to Genesis 1. They believed, you can see it in the Genesis 1 text. God created the light of the moon to light this. That, it was a functional, everything had a function. God created this for us to do this. And I believe that they weren't concerned about material origins. They didn't know the moon was a rock that was reflecting the sun. And I don't expect the Bible to tell me that. I think it's concerned about what is God trying to say about himself an ancient Near Eastern culture, not to me. It's arrogance, it's Enlightenment arrogance. And I believe that creationists are just as much products of the arrogant Enlightenment as scientists are, because they're trying to make the Bible into something that, into a 21st century document, which it is not. And I'm respecting that God chose to speak to a culture that wasn't the 21st century utopia when human beings finally discovered that you can use reason and science. That's my point. Here I'll be born again tomorrow. Well, I kind of... I do agree that God created the rose, and I don't think that humans are intelligent enough yet to be able to make a rose, and they may never will be, because I don't worship human beings as this. Yeah.